Once it would have been unthinkable for Southwark to return anything but a Labour administration. But times change. The docks, which were the lifeblood of this area, withered and died. In the wake came unemployment, 16% in some parts, and the traditional politics began to undergo traumatic changes too. Epitomised lately by the thin, tall figure of Peter Tatchell, adopted by Labour in Bermondsey to replace Bob Mellish after 36 years as MP. Mr Tatchell's left-wing views and the manner of his selection became a national crisis for the Labour Party. And Southwark's leftward swing affected the town hall too. Come the emergence of the SDP, so too came Labour defectors. But some of the bitterness which resulted in this mix-out is still embarrassingly obvious today.
For instance, this is Riverside Ward, where the political choices may look straightforward enough. There are three Conservative candidates, three Labour candidates, and three Alliance candidates. But in reality, the political choices are far more baffling for the voter here, because there are also three independent Labour candidates and two under the banner SDP. Now, those last two names and one other candidate from another ward were last night formally expelled from the Social Democratic Party. All three had been long-standing Labour councillors here in Southwark. All three had expected, when they defected to the SDP, to be picked by the Social Democrats as official candidates. And when they weren't, they decided to go it alone. But they used official SDP literature.
But while the political splits are now showing, all around, the real problems of this borough are every bit as obvious. Derelict land, poor housing. It isn't a part of the world in which the Conservatives ever expect to flourish. They do have their strongholds further south, where the grass is greener and the inhabitants better off, in places like Dulwich. But the campaigning flak comes to the surface as political loyalties are stretched, as some Labour traditionalists warn Labour voters not to vote Labour. So control of this town hall was once a foregone conclusion. But signs are now that Southwark's voters may make it a much closer finish. Ed Boyle, Thames News.